Good evening, sir. My name is Subhash Kamble. I am lecturer from Chemistry Department, Thana College. In the beginning of your lecture, you said that Quran talks about giving peace to humanity. My question is that if it is talking about peace, then why so many young men from various countries are falling to the prey of terrorism in the name of jihad? What is the concept of jihad? Thank you, sir.
The brother asked a good question, that if Islam and Quran speak about peace to humanity, then how come there are so many young Muslims and other Muslims from different countries who are fighting and who are talking about jihad? What is the concept of jihad? As far as the word jihad is concerned, jihad comes from the Arabic word jahada, which means to strive. It means to struggle. So jihad basically means to strive against struggle. Jihad does not mean holy war. Holy war, if you translate to Arabic, means harbu muqaddasa. There is no Arabic word harbu muqaddasa in the Quran or any of the Sahih Hadith. This is a mistranslation by the media and the Orientalists. There is no holy war. Jihad does not mean holy war. Jihad means to strive, to struggle. Furthermore, in Islamic context, it means to strive and struggle to improve the humanity. It means to strive and struggle to bring peace in humanity. It also means to strive and struggle in the battlefield in self-defense. It also means to strive and struggle against oppression. Jihad basically means to strive and struggle. Now coming to your question, that how come then so many youngsters from different countries, they are fighting? Point number one, there are possibilities, and it's a fact, that some of the Muslims, they are being misled by the antisocial elements. That fight, it's there in Islam, etc., misquoting out of context. But this is a small percentage. The major reason, according to me, is how the media portrays. Like in India, we very often read in the newspapers that the Muslim terrorist in Kashmir, killing so many people, headlines. Regularly you read. I was called to Kashmir the first time in 2003. And I was thinking, should I go or not? Should I go or not? So much of chaos. First time in Kashmir, the government gave permission after 14 years to hold a public lecture. And the gathering was somewhat big, 100,000 people. In polo grounds, in the city of Srinagar. And when I went there, there were guards, you know, with guns and all around me. And I was expecting, but there wasn't much problem. Next day, I went to Assam. I landed on the airport. There were four guards with guns, machine guns. What is this? There is killing in Assam. Killing in Assam? Where it takes place? And there, if I did not have the guards, I wouldn't be here to give the talk. But in the papers, where do we hear about the killing going on in Assam? There are more people being killed in Assam than in Kashmir. Who hears about the LTT? You know the LTT? The Tamilians, they are called as Tamil Tigers. They are not called as Hindu terrorists. Why? If Kashmiri Muslims do it, they are called as Muslim terrorists. If the Hindus in Assam do it, it's a local problem. If the LTT does it, local problem. In India, you ask anyone who has the knowledge of law and order, he will tell you the maximum killing is done by the Maoist. How many times do we read in the newspaper? If we read in the newspaper, in news brief, okay, so many people killed in Assam. News brief. Muslims do it, headlines. Why? There are black sheep in every community. Then one person came and told me, you know, you should understand, this is a problem of land. Assam is not a problem of land. It is the Kashmir which is a problem of land. Both the countries are fighting and the poor Kashmiris are being, they are being harassed. Neither here, neither there. If you go to Afghanistan, that's a problem of land. The Americans have come there, and you call them terrorists. See what's happening in Palestine. The Jews were kicked out by Hitler, kicked out from Germany. The Palestinians, the Arab cousins, they said, Ahlan wa sahlan, you are most welcome in a house. Now imagine, suppose a traveler is homeless, without a roof, you allow him to come to your house. After a few days, he kicks you out, and at the doorstep, you're saying, he has taken my house, give my house back. They call you a terrorist. What terrorist? So you realize this is the media. It is media. What we realize, what's happening in Bosnia? The Muslims, correct, I do agree with you. The Muslims are coming in the picture, but they are being harassed. Where is humanity? What have we done for the people of Palestine? For the people of Iraq? Weapons of mass destruction. I'm not in favor of Saddam Hussein. I don't consider a good Muslim. But there were problems when Saddam was ruling. After the Americans came, the problems are multiplied. Correct? So what do you talk about weapons of mass destruction? So what we realize, brother, it is the media. The Muslims are being harassed. They are the sufferers, and you call them terrorists. So that's the reason. But there are black sheep in the community also. But the black sheep are a minority. It's a minority. The major thing is the media. You know, IRA, Irish Republican Army in UK. It is a fight between the Catholics and the Protestants. No one calls them as Catholic terrorists. Why? More than 100 years. But Tony Blair and the new Prime Minister are more worried about Muslim terrorists. They aren't worried about IRA, which has killed hundreds of people. How many bomb blasts have they done? They are more having secret meetings about how to stop Muslim terrorists. And it's very common. Any politician, he wants a vote bank. The new Prime Minister came, then the Jasco bombing. You know Sabil Ahmed? Have you heard Sabil Ahmed? Very good. I have heard him, I haven't seen him. It came in the Indian papers. You know Sabil Ahmed? Sabil Ahmed was a fan of Dr. Zakir Naik. And he organized Dr. Zakir Naik's lecture in Bangalore in the full article on terrorism. Then they talk about Sabil Ahmed. Then they talk about Dr. Zakir Naik. Why? Because Dr. Zakir Naik is popular. Article will carry more weight. Then they continue saying that Dr. Zakir Naik, however, is vehemently against terrorism. They include my name in the article. You know the issue of Lal Masjid in Pakistan. CDs were found of Dr. Zakir Naik. So you should be happy. When the Indian press is saying Dr. Zakir Naik is against terrorism, you should be happy that Sabil Ahmed has made DVDs. You should be happy that Lal Masjid has made DVDs. If I'm against terrorism, so you should realize that maybe there were tens of thousands of Muslims who had done terrorist act because they are my fans, they have stopped doing terrorism. Because if a person is sick, he has to go to a doctor. Correct? So you can't say that sick people are going to the hospital. A sick person should go to the hospital. So if you assume that these are terrorist organizations and they're hearing my lectures, the Indian government should be happy. When Dr. Zakir Naik speaks against terrorism, they should be happy that these people are listening to me. I may not be able to convince everyone, but at least quite a few I'm convincing. But in the article, they write my name for weightage. You know, so it becomes, if you write against Islam, the chances the article will be selected very easy. And that's common. Same with Kushwant Singh. You know Kushwant Singh? Now his age is 94. Year before last, he wrote an article against me. Couple of weeks back in November, he wrote an article against me. He says, in the first article he mentioned, that I watch Dr. Zakir Naik's program religiously every day. He writes. He praises me, talks about my memory, and then criticizes me in his style. Again, he wrote an article that in Delhi, there was a book exhibition, and the hot seller was Dr. Zakir Naik's book on answers to the 20 common questions asked by non-Muslims. Oh, that person has fantastic memory, blah, 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 blah. But I will reply to four of his questions. And he replies to pork, to alcohol, to polygamy, as well as parda, hijab. And you read the article. Time will not permit him to speak about everything. In pork, I say that it's the most shameless animal, more than 70 diseases. It is the only animal that invites its friends to have sex with the meat. So I said, if you eat pig, you behave like pig. It is the only animal that invites its friends to have sex with the maid. He said, I did not know that. And he says that, I don't know the Western country, they're having pig, and I don't see any epidemic or any disease. See, doctors tell us today that don't go to a prostitute, you'll have AIDS. But everyone that goes to prostitute does not get AIDS. The percentage is small. The minority of the people get. Similarly, everyone that I spoke doesn't get these diseases. But today, more than 50% of the Americans, they are suffering from hypertension. And one of the causes is because of pig eating. He talks about alcoholism. Dr. Zakir Naik says, because of alcohol, you have so many diseases. So he says, Quran is not against alcohol, it's against getting intoxicated. Now he's trying to interpret the Quran. This is the media. And he says, I am of the age of 94 years old. I am drinking every day in my life. I've never got intoxicated. I've never got sick. And I've never hurt any individual. Now all these three things, age of 94, has never got intoxicated. I know so many common friends who tell me that they have seen him intoxicated so many times. Never seen a doctor. Maybe he forgot, age of 94. He has never hurt anyone. He has hurt me. So what we realize that when you write articles against Islam, against people who are famous, you get good readership. You get good viewership. So similarly, you realize that today that the image that we have of Muslims are terrorists. Some may be fighting for the freedom of the country. Imagine if I tell you that the British government said Bhagat Singh was a terrorist. Was Bhagat Singh a terrorist? Was he or not?
Yes, sir.
Was Bhagat Singh a terrorist or not?
His act was like terrorist.
But was he a terrorist according to
no.
you? According to me also, he was not a terrorist. But just because the British government says that Bhagat Singh is a terrorist, that doesn't mean I have to agree with the British government. What we have to realize, this is major the ploy of the media. That's the reason this talk was based on that, so that we can spread peace. Hope that answers the question.
Thank you, sir.